In the name of God, who is most merciful and passionate. Students, assalamu alaikum. My name is Dr. Nayyar Iqbal. Students, you watching Math Home YouTube channel, and we are have started already additional mathematics. And students, in this video lecture, I am going to start a topic of your trigonometry, that is trigonometric identities. Students, you know very well about the trigonometric functions. There are 6 trigonometric functions. For example, trigonometric functions of angle theta, that is sine theta, cosine theta, tangent theta, cotangent theta, secant theta, and cosecant theta. Students, you know secant theta is a reciprocal of cosine theta. Similarly, cosecant theta is a reciprocal of sine theta. And in this way, cotangent theta is also a reciprocal of tangent theta. Students, these 6 trigonometric functions are very important, and in this lecture we shall derive fundamental identities. So students, what are the fundamental identities? Sine square theta plus cosine square theta, this is first fundamental identity. And then 1 plus tangent square theta is equal to secant square theta, this is second fundamental identity. And 1 plus cotangent square theta is equal to cosecant square theta, this is third fundamental identity. We shall derive these fundamental identities also in this lecture. Student, why I select this topic from trigonometry? Because I see in almost many papers, you can say in almost every paper, there is a question from this portion of trigonometry. So this part of trigonometry, that is known as trigonometric identities, is very important for you. So students, from this lecture we shall start this topic, and I shall solve all these questions, all the questions from this topic which are in your past 10-year papers. So students, very interesting topic we are going to start. So see the trigonometric identities. Students, this is lecture 1. First of all, we define trigonometric functions. Trigonometric functions. The trigonometric functions there are 6 trigonometric functions, that is sine theta, cosine theta, tangent theta, cotangent theta, secant theta, and cosecant theta. Note number 1. Students, this cosecant theta, this is a reciprocal of sine theta. So cosecant theta can be written as 1 over sine theta, or you can write here as sine theta is equal to 1 over cosecant theta. Similarly, students, secant theta, this is reciprocal of cosine theta. And therefore, you can write cosine theta is equal to 1 over secant theta. Number 3rd, you know students, what is tangent theta? Tangent theta is actually sine theta divided by cosine theta. And similarly, cotangent theta can be written as cos theta divided by sin theta. Number 5, students, this cotangent theta is actually reciprocal of tangent theta. Therefore, we can write as tangent theta is equal to 1 over cotangent theta. So, students, now we write here what are the fundamental identities. We try fundamental identities. That is, fundamental identities. So students, see here, we know sine square theta plus cosine square theta is equal to 1. This is equation 1. If we divide this equation by cosine square theta on both sides, so we have sine square theta divided by cosine square theta plus cosine square theta divided by cosine square theta. This is 1 over cosine square theta. Students, you know sine over cos is sine over cosine is tangent theta, that is square. Therefore we write here tangent square theta plus cosine square theta divided by cosine square theta, that is 1, and 1 over cosine, you know, secant. Therefore we write here secant square theta. This is second fundamental identity. Now dividing equation 1 by sine square theta. Now we divide this equation 1 by sine square theta. Therefore we have sine square theta divided by sine square theta plus cosine square theta divided by sine square theta, that is 1 over sine square theta. Therefore we have 1 plus, you know, cos over sine is cotangent. Therefore this can be written as cotangent square theta. 1 over sine is cosecant. Therefore it is written as cosecant square theta. This is 3 equation. These three equations are called fundamental identities. So the equations 1, 2 and 3 are called fundamental identities. Fundamental identities of trigonometry. These are called fundamental identities of trigonometry. Okay students, now we start questions from your past papers. We start here. So therefore, so students, see here, this is question number 6, first part. This is paper 2, October-November 2016 proof. So we consider its left hand side. Students, see here, we take its left hand side, that is cos x 1 plus tangent x minus sine x divided by 1 plus cotangent x. So what we know, students, you know tangent x is equal to sine x divided by cos x, and cotangent x is equal to cos x divided by sine x. Therefore we write here cos x, that is 1 plus sine x divided by cos x. Similarly here sine x divided by 1 plus cos x over sine x. Now students, see here, this cos x cosine x is LCM of denominator, and it multiply with numerator. Therefore in numerator we have cos square x, and in denominator we have sine x plus cos x. Similarly here we have sine square x and divided by साइन एक्स प्लस कॉस एक्स. स्टूडेंट्स वी टेक एलसीएम ऑफ दीज टू टर्म्स. देयरफॉर इफ वी टेक एलसीएम दैट इज साइन एक्स प्लस कॉस एक्स. देयरफॉर ऑन न्यूमिरेटर वी हैव कॉस स्क्वायर एक्स माइनस साइन स्क्वायर एक्स. स्टूडेंट्स इन अलजबरा यू नो इफ फेमस देयर इज ए फेमस फार्मूला दैट इज इफ ए प्लस बी इज मल्टीप्लाई बाय ए माइनस बी वी हैव ए स्क्वायर माइनस बी स्क्वायर. बाय अप्लाइंग दिस फार्मूला बिकॉज हेयर वी हैव ए स्क्वायर माइनस बी स्क्वायर सो वी हैव दिस इज ए प्लस बी मल्टीप्लाई बाय ए माइनस बी होल डिवाइडेड बाय साइन एक्स प्लस कोसाइन एक्स एंड यू सी दिस फैक्टर इज कैंसल आउट. देयरफॉर वी हैव एट द एंड वी हैव कोसाइन एक्स माइनस साइन एक्स एंड दिस इज आवर राइट हैंड साइड. सो सिमिलरली स्टूडेंट्स वी स्टार्ट आवर नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. सी हियर स्टूडेंट्स दिस क्वेश्चन इज इन योर पेपर 2 मई जून 2011. क्वेश्चन 4 पार्ट ए प्रूव दैट 1 ओवर 1 माइनस साइन एक्स प्लस 1 ओवर 1 प्लस साइन एक्स इज इक्वल टू 2 टेंजेंट एक्स इंटू सीकेंट एक्स. सो हियर वी राइट प्रूफ. अगेन वी टेक लेफ्ट हैंड साइड दैट इज 1 माइनस साइन एक्स प्लस 1 प्लस साइन एक्स. स्टूडेंट्स वी टेक इट्स एलसीएम यू नो दैट इज 1 माइनस साइन एक्स मल्टीप्लाई बाय 1 प्लस साइन एक्स एंड इन न्यूमिरेटर दिस फैक्टर इज कैंसल आउट विद दिस फैक्टर. देयरफॉर वी हैव 1 प्लस साइन एक्स प्लस 1 माइनस साइन एक्स. स्टूडेंट्स इन डिनोमिनेटर इन प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन यू नो वी राइट ए माइनस बी एंड ए प्लस बी अलजबरिकली दैट इज इक्वल टू ए स्केयर माइनस बी स्केयर. बाय यूजिंग दिस फार्मूला वी राइट दैट इज 2 डिवाइडेड बाय 1 माइनस साइन स्केयर एक्स बिकॉज 1 स्केयर इज 1. नो 1 माइनस साइन स्केयर एक्स यू नो द फंडामेंटल आइडेंटिटी फर्स्ट. फ्रॉम देयर वी हैव 2 ओवर 1 cos square x. Therefore, this is 2 secant square x. This is its right hand side. But here in this question you see the right hand side is 2 tangent x and secant x. How we get this term 2 tangent x and secant x? Students if we check this one 1 over 1 minus sin x plus 1 over 1 plus we take its LCM. Okay, 1 plus sin x plus 1 minus sin x this is. Okay students, this is right hand side. I think there is a correction in the term that if we write here negative sign, if we write here negative sign, then I think we get the right hand side. This will be correct. Or okay, now we take left hand side as 1 over 1 minus sin x minus 1 over 1 plus sin x. Students if we simplify this one, so see here again LCM is 1 minus sin x multiply by 1 plus sin x and in numerator you see 1 plus sin x minus. We write here 1 minus sin x, this minus change sign plus sin x. So in this way students we have on numerator 2 sin x and in denominator we have 1 minus cos 1 minus sin square x. and this is equal to 2 sine x divided by cos square x. So students, if we simplify this this factor, so students see here, that is 2 sine x divided by, this is cos square x, you can write it cos x into cos x, and you see sine over cos becomes tangent and 1 over cos become secant. Therefore we have 2 tangent x into secant x, and this is our right hand side. So students, see here, we solve this question. If there is plus sign, then we get 2 secant square x. If there is negative sign in between these two terms, we get exactly the right hand side. So students, now we come to our next question. Student, this is the question. This is a question in your paper 1, October, November 2010. Question is that we prove this question. See here, left hand side. So we take here left hand side, that is cosine x divided by 1 minus sine x plus cos x divided by 1 plus sine x. Students, again we take LCM, that is 1 minus sine x multiplied by 1 plus sine x. 1 minus sine x is cancelled out with this one, so cosine x will multiply this 1 plus sine x. We have cos x plus cosine x into sine x, that is plus. No, 1 plus sine x is cancelled out with this factor, and cos x will multiply this one, that is cos x minus cosine x into sine x, and you see this factor is cancelled out with this factor. So we have on numerator we have 2 cosine x, and again we apply here a formula from algebra, a minus b, a plus b, this is equal to a square minus b square. Therefore this is 1 minus sin square x. And students, you know 1 minus sin square x, you know we have a fundamental identity, you know we have a fundamental identity, that is sin square theta plus cosine square theta is equal to 1. From this fundamental identity, you see we have 2 cosine x over cosine square x. Therefore 1 cosine x will be cancelled out, and the remaining 1 over cos x gives us secant x, and this is our right hand side. So students, now we come to our next question. Students, this is a question IGCSE 0603 paper 21 November 2013. Question is that show that this term is equal to 2 secant theta. So its proof, we take again consider left hand side, that is 1 plus sin theta divided by cos theta plus divided by 1 plus sin theta. So students, as usual, we take their LCM, that is cos theta and 1 plus sin theta. See here, cos theta is cancelled out with this factor, and 1 plus sin theta is multiplied by this factor, that gives us 1 plus sin theta, its square, plus cos theta multiplied by this one, that is cos square theta. Now we open this square, that is a plus b square algebraically. Therefore 1 plus sine square theta, that is a square plus b square, plus 2 ab and plus cos square theta divided by, this is cos theta into 1 plus sine theta. Students, see here, this sin square theta and cos square theta first fundamental identity it results gives us 1. Therefore we have 1 plus 1 plus 2 sin theta and divided by cosine theta into 1 plus sin theta. So this 1 plus 1 gives us 2, 2 plus 2 sin theta divided by cos theta into 1 plus sin of theta. See here students, if we take 2 common, so we have 1 plus sin theta and divided by this is cos theta and 1 plus sin theta. Students, this factor is cancelled out with this factor. Therefore, at the end we have 2 and 1 over cos theta is secant theta. That is secant theta and this is our right hand side. So we come to our next question. So student, this question is in your two papers, paper 2 October-November 2017 and paper 1 October-November 2013. This is a question which is two time in your past papers. So we solve this question. See here students, again we consider its left hand side, that is sin x divided by 1 plus cos x plus 1 plus cos x divided by sin x. Students, in LCM you see sin x and 1 plus cos x. Here 1 plus cos x is cancelled out with this one, so sin will multiply with this one, so there we have sin square x plus sin x is cancelled out with this one and plus 1 plus cos x square, because this 1 plus cos x is multiplied by this one, so we open this square. Therefore we have sin square x plus 1 plus cos square x plus 2 cosine x and divided by sin x into 1 plus cos x. This sin square plus cos square gives us 1. Therefore we have 1 plus 1 plus 2 cos x divided by this is sin x into 1 plus cos x. Mean cos x mean cosine x. So students, this is 2, that is 2 plus 2 cosine x and sin x into 1 plus cos x. We take 2 from common from the numerator, so we have 1 plus cos x and divided by this is sin x and 1 plus cos x. Students, this is cancel out and 2 over sin, 1 over sin is cosecant. Therefore we have 2 cosecant x and this is your right hand side. So we come our next question. See students, this question is in paper 1 403711 May June 2011. Okay, we solve this question. See here, we take its left hand side, that is 1 minus cosine theta plus 1 over 1 plus cosine theta. Students, again we take its LCM, that is 1 minus cos theta and 1 plus cos theta. This 1 minus cos theta cancel out, we have 1 plus cos theta plus 1 minus cos theta. So this factor is cancel out. Therefore we have 2 in numerator and denominator. Again students, very popular formula of algebra, a minus b and a plus b multiplied and then gives a square minus b square, that is 1 minus cos square theta. And 1 minus cos square theta, you know the fundamental identity gives us 2 over sin square theta. and this 1 over sine square becomes cosecant square, therefore we have 2 cosecant square theta, and this is our right hand side. So students, know we come over next question. Students, this is a question from your Cambridge textbook. So we solve this question. Students, we take its left hand side, that is cosine x, cosecant x plus 1 plus cosine x, cosecant x minus 1. Students, we know what is cosecant x. This is a reciprocal of sine x. Therefore, we have 1 over sine x plus 1. Similarly, here we have 1 over sine x minus 1. Students, you know this sine x is LCM of this denominator, and this multiply by cos x. Therefore, we have numerator sine x cos x divided by 1 plus sine x. Similarly, we have sine x multiply by cos x and 1 minus sine x. Now we take their LCM. If we take the LCM, that is 1 plus sine x and 1 minus sine x. So 1 plus sine x is cancel out with this one, and 1 minus sine x will multiply by this this one. So if we take students, if we take common, that is 1 minus sine x plus 1 plus sine x, this factor sine x and cos x, we take it as a common factor. So student, this minus sine x is cancelled out with this plus sine x. So we have 2, this is sine x and cos x. In denominator we have 1 minus sine square x. So 2 sine x multiply by cos x, and in denominator we have cos square x. 1 cosine is cancelled out with this one, so we have 2 sine x divided by cos x. This gives us 2 tangent x, and this is our right hand side. So students, this was the last question of this exercise. Now I give you 3 questions for homework. This is here. So students, these are the 3 questions for your homework. These are very simple questions. You try at home. Inshallah, in next lecture I shall solve here some more questions from your past papers. So students, take care. Meet you in next lecture.